Hey, if it ain't hood, it ain't good. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, thanks for liking, subscribing. Welcome to the Hood Podcast. Back at it again with another episode of Hood Review. Spoiler alerts as always, as we review Fallout, the prime TV show based off of the video game. Joined as always, we got the homies. Got my boy Roy Yama. What's going on, sir?
What's good?
And we this nigga locked in. And we have the lovely Chris. How are you, Chris?
I'm expecting the worst and hoping for the best.
Okay, so straight off the bat, we have a Amazon Prime TV show, Fallout, based off of a video game. Chris, we kind of have some PTSD, like, about that, like some recent trauma, right?
Yes.
Okay. Roy Yama, I think you've played almost all the Fallouts, as I have.
I've played every single Fallout except Fallout Tactics.
Okay, I played 1 and 2, but I'm not going to count that because, oh boy.
You're not going to count 1 and 2?
That was rough, man. Oh, that was a rough ride. I don't think my brain didn't really comprehend it back then. Depends on when you get to it. It definitely depends on your maturity level.
And it also depends on the era you played it in, right?
True.
At the time yes. I was playing it, yep. It was still pretty good graphics.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think about that.
So, spoiler alerts as always, if you haven't seen episode 1 yet, I would recommend that you do that. I wouldn't do that for other video game made TV shows, but for this one, yeah. Right off the bat, what'd y'all think about the first episode of Fallout?
Okay. First of all, I went into my Amazon Prime account and I started Fallout, and it was like, hey man, this now Prime Video includes limited advertisement interruption.
No.
And I was like, yo, like, fucking lying to me.
As soon as you open it up, as soon as you open it up to watch Fallout, they'd be like, give me $3. Give me $3 real quick. I get back.
Taking out your coin purse.
I just need about $3.50.
I almost just closed it out right then and there.
Oh no. Okay.
Oh, you mean that all together? It made me do that for some show. I forgot what it was. I was about to watch it, and that popped up. I was like, "Peace out."
Yeah. But I tell you what though, I did go through. I said I watched it, and you know what? I am not so far. I am not disappointed. I am not disappointed.
Yay!
So far,
Chris. What about you?
So I'm coming from the perspective of someone who's only watched other people play Fallout.
Okay.
And good so enough. Far, I thought episode 1 was, it was catchy. Like, I'm interested to see what happens next.
Got you hooked.
Mm-hmm. I do.
Why? It has me interested. I don't want to overplay my hand here.
Okay.
I do feel sorry for a lot of people who are just coming into Fallout and just have no fucking clue what's going on, because they didn't explain a lot of it. They did not. And they just throw you right into all the wackiness.
Yeah.
Actually, I like that about it. Like, because, like, I've seen people play the game, but it's like years and years ago. So a lot of the stuff I don't remember. But, like, I kind of got, okay, they had to go underground because bombs got dropped. So, of course you would. And of course there would be a split.
You better.
You don't really need to over-explain a lot of this stuff. It's not like these are new, super new concepts as far as media goes. But the way it's a little bit silly, and the people, the vault people are stupid naive, it seems.
The vault is really the majority of the Fallout story. Considering like how like the post-apocalyptic surface is,
right?
Most of the heavy hitter main characters are coming from as vault dwellers. Correct me if I'm wrong, Roy Yama.
So I think the first one you're not a vault dweller. The second one you are a vault dweller, And it goes back and forth like that. Because yeah, the third one you are, the fourth Vegas you are not.
The fourth
Vegas you were a courier.
Vegas, yeah, Vegas you got hoed.
Yeah, and then and then the fourth one you are again. So it kind of goes back and forth.
Yeah, fourth one. Okay, yeah. Fourth one, I'll give you four.
You were definitely like a barbarian. And then the second four. One, you were a vault dweller.
I'll barely give you four.
Oh, no.
Four, you were definitely a vault dweller.
But you dwell in the vault.
But you didn't dwell in the vault. You
didn't dwell, but you were in the vault. You were in the vault, but you did not dwell.
You took a nap in the vault. It's not like you came out with vault dwellers.
Oh, shoot. Wait. Yeah. So it sounds like you're the LaCroix of vault dwellers in that one.
Like you're a diet vault dweller?
You were close enough.
What was the
vault? You are a generic version.
In
like great value vault dweller.
In Fallout 4, in four. The vault number? It was one. Was it 111?
Probably.
Was it 111?
That sounds right. I think that was the only three-digit one I remember.
The thing is, all the vaults have a purpose, right? Yeah. They're like these great big experiments that like Vault-Tec is doing on people. And the vault in 4 was like, how does the human body respond to like cryogenic freezing?
Yeah.
And like,
yeah, some of them were horrible. Yeah.
Yeah.
Some of them were great.
And they freeze you and you wake up 200 years later.
And some of the vaults were social experiments as well.
Yeah. Like 31, 32, and 33 and 32 being in the show. I think 33 was made so that they could see how humans would react to being overthrown by AI. And then 32 was to be used as a breeding pool for humanity. Because all the people there had desirable traits. You know, they were tall and pretty and.
So in the breeding one, was it like a bigger vault in the game? Because it seemed like it was a pretty small space.
I've never seen seen Vault 33 or 32 in the game. I've seen Vault 34, okay. I think. But they made sure they were very specific.
They were very specific with their vault choice, which was
vaults.
Shout out to the game developers being involved too.
The reason people know about the vaults is because of the lore.
Yep.
Like you go in and you look through at all like the notes and stuff like that, and they and people like chronicle what the vaults are for and stuff.
Yeah, it's so like vast lore too.
Yeah, there's a lot of lore. There's a lot of lore. There's a Vault 69.
What? So there's a rabbit hole to go down?
It's like there's like one dude and all women. It's like one dude and like 100 women.
Okay. Yep. And then they got the other one where it's 100 like women and one dude too.
One dude. There's 100 dudes and one woman.
They got both.
They did. They flipped it. Yeah.
Yeah, they got both.
68, 69.
The fuck is that?
The Hood Podcast.
Let's get the fuck out of this country, motherfucker.